The 21 soldiers who are here for a two-week visit will be participating in the Independence Military Parade. This is a special occasion since it has been some time since there has been this kind of participation of the British Army in the island's independence celebrations. The trip back home was entirely conceived by the soldiers who had a bit of nostalgia for their homeland. Staff Sergeant Neive Darcheville echoed the sentiments of his fellow brothers in arms, who are more than elated to be back.
For me, my family never had the opportunity to see me pass out from basic training, and I could speak for a few other guys here with me. So that's an opportunity to have your family and friends, you know, to see you actually on a parade. We're looking forward to engage with the public because earlier on this morning, we had so many people, you know, coming up to us, asking questions, taking photos and that. I mean, being that is the first time, you know, the reception is very good.
Governor General Sir Emmanuel Neville Cenac was delighted to welcome the men when they paid an official visit to Government House on Wednesday. He encouraged the men to continue serving their nation proudly abroad and not to pass up the opportunity to invest in it.
When I think of the diaspora, I think of the Jews being scattered. You're not scattered as they were, but they always had one hope, one song they sang, tomorrow to Jerusalem. Their country. St. Lucia is your Jerusalem. I'm so very happy to see you.
Resident British High Commissioner Steve McCready, who was also on hand during the visit, says this undertaking by the soldiers punctuates the relationship between the United Kingdom and St. Lucia.
The first thing I would say, Your Excellency, is I feel like I'm no more than a freeloader here, maybe at best a facilitator. And the reason I say that is because this trip has been entirely conceived by the officers themselves. And I particularly look at Staff Sergeant Darcheville here. The first I heard about this visit was when Senator Belrose phoned me up and said, "Do you know anything about a group of British Army St. Lucians who want to come for independence?" I said, "No." She said, "What do you think of that idea?" And it took me less than a split second to say, "That's one of the most wonderful things I've heard in my time here." I can think of no better statement, gentlemen, about the St. Lucian UK friendship than all of you being here, especially for St. Lucia's 41st independence celebrations. It's a marvellous thing. I'd have to say that the few years I've been here, every year, Your Excellency, I've had people say, "Why can't we have members of the British Armed Forces here?" You have made that happen. So linking up your friendship, Your Excellency, with your visit, gentlemen, I think is a marvellous, marvellous thing.
During their two-week visit, the men will be engaged in other activities apart from the military parade on Saturday. Already, they have visited the Methodist and Groseley Primary Schools and made a donation to the St. Lucia Blind Welfare Association. The men will also meet with the Cadet Corps, and come Friday, they will be doing a beautification exercise at the VG Multipurpose Complex in collaboration with the Make It Happen Foundation. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.